因为我觉得呢，从中国目前倡导的这个"一带一路"建设的过程当中，非常需要搭建一个中国的企业走出去和境外的国家互相合作的这样一个平台和纽带，或者说桥梁和纽带。所以我觉得这样一个会议呢搞得非常好。虽然我也是第一次参加类似的会议，但是从目前的情况看，我觉得还是非常有必要。特别是呢，很多中国的公司在响应，在觉得国家这个"一带一路"战略是对他们一个很大的机会的时候，他们也需要更多的去了解国外的事情。那么，通过你们这样的一个主办，能够使国外的这个政府机构、企业和各方面的人士来到中国，和中国的有意愿的投资者，有这样的一个平台进行充分的交流和沟通，彼此了解各自的想法，对他们、对我们都是一个很好的一个发展的这个交流的一个形式和机会。我觉得应该多国的举办。当然，现在虽然说大家很多人说这个网上的平台信息量已经很大了，但是我觉得任何重大的投资也好，合作也好，人和人之间面对面的交流是最基本的条件。
And so that's why I'm here. I'm the free trade. I represent the free trade zone of the Bahamas, and the free trade zone of the Bahamas, Grand Bahama Freeport, is considered to be the industrial capital of the Bahamas. We have perhaps the most diverse economy in the Bahamas right now.And so we're looking to be the catalyst or kind of lead the way in diversifying the economy of the Bahamas. I was telling him maybe next year, but I decided to attend. And I must say that I've been very impressed so far. It's only been a few hours, but we've received significant inquiries. A lot of the leads that I've gotten so far appear to be very promising.And so I think this will probably be one of the better conferences or summits that we've actually participated in for this year.
There were a lot of benefits in attending today's conference because we managed to meet a number of potential investors that were very keen in looking at our special economic zones as well as our industrial hubs. They want to actually put some of their business into those regions. The second thing, we got to market and expose our region to a market that we've never touched on before. And the audience was quite receptive to listening to a number of opportunities that come from our region.
Signed an agreement with Shenzhen to establish an industrial estate for Chinese investors. And so we have already attracted several Chinese investment companies to produce high value added, high tech products. And it's really considered an epicenter, a focal point for Chinese investment in the region. This is beyond the very, very useful and precise, beyond benefiting from the presentations and the discussions by panelists, which have been very focused on economic zones and trade areas around the world that deal with China. We have also been able to benefit from networking with other colleagues and counterparts in the various areas, and mostly from meeting with Chinese investors and Chinese officials who want to facilitate investment in Jordan, Aqaba, our special economic zone.
As we say, the early bird catches the worm. So my message to Chinese investors and finance companies is to really study about having a presence in Djibouti so that they're visible to the African customer and they can access the African client. I mean, it's very simple. If you look at Volkswagen today in China, they have one of the biggest market share as a Western car manufacturer. And the reason is very simple. They were here first. They established their manufacturing in the 1970s, so they gained market share. So my message to Chinese companies is that the sooner you are, the sooner you have a presence in a place like Djibouti to have access to this big market, such as COMESA with 400 million people, the better for you. But otherwise, the next guy will, and you will lose out, and you will have very little market share. Oh, the conference today has been absolutely fantastic so far. We were very excited about participating in this conference. And of course, we are also silver sponsors of this event because we believe an event of this nature is exactly what's required to create awareness among the Chinese business community about the opportunities that are available in Africa and how they can take advantage of those opportunities in terms of, you know, where they can set up in Africa to access the market. So we've had a number of Chinese companies that visited our stand today, and of course our presentation with our chairman's speech was well received. So yeah, it's been very, it's been fantastic, and we're looking more forward to engaging more with the Chinese business community in the coming years with more events of this nature.
I think our Prime Minister visited China. He was speaking with the President and the Prime Minister for development of the relation and also talking about certain economic types and also some sphere and sectors of business. We have now several investments done by Chinese companies, especially in infrastructure regarding the road, railway, and also I think that there will be more into a tunnel system that will be developed in our country, that is in our region, because we are represented here in the northern part of Serbia, actually the province of Vojvodina. Here we were invited as a delegation from Serbia in order to achieve meetings and actually access to the Chinese companies, especially for Shanghai. And it was opportunity for us actually in direct contact to provide them with the knowledge of where we are and also to provide the benefits for the Chinese companies how to actually. And for Summit, it was opportunity to directly address to the Chinese investors, because for us that is the opportunity and the, let's say, we are not practicing it more, and these summits and to address Chinese investors, it is the best way to come here, yes, to address them directly.
Well, from my side, there seems to be a general misconception about the stability of Djibouti as a region. And it's been very useful for me to spend some time to dispel those fears and to explain the size of the investment of China in Djibouti, as well as the investment in other Western countries, and why, therefore, it's stable and a good place to invest.
Djibouti government has made a place for us, and has given us 99 years. 所以我们可以把它表述成就是完全建设一座新的城市，一座全新的城市。城市里面所具有的功能，在我们这个经济特区里面都会有。所以我们是这个经济特区的投资方、运营方，也是建设方。通常来讲，就是我们中国企业到海外去投资比较关心，一个呢是所谓证据稳定或者不稳定；第二个呢就是人员是否安全；第三个呢就是资金能不能够自由的进出。 那第四个呢，就是还有就是那个市场到底有多大？那实际上吉布提这个地方呢，应该说是一个非常安全的地方，而且它的经济呢也是很开放的，它的腹地经济也很广，所以我觉得就是说中国企业可以考虑到吉布提这个地方去投资，它应该是个蛮不错的一个地方，因为它也很安全。我呢是第一次来参加你们这个峰会，但是呢，我觉得这个峰会应该说是办得非常好。 就是各方面也都有充足的时间来交流自己的观点，还有呢，就是从我们建设经济特区这个角度来讲呢，我们也可以从其他的经济特区那边学到一些经验，所以我觉得这是一个很不错的平台，希望你们可以把它搞得更好吧。